Right, and I'm in charge. So, let's begin. I have decided what to do with the money. I'm going to split it four ways. Nicole and Maeve, Eddie and Esther, Eric and Ginny, and me. Well?
We can't take your money.
Why not?
Because you deserve to be treated like a queen. No, go on a holiday, buy a new wardrobe, diamond rings, do whatever you want.
Well, that's a lovely thing to say, but you don't mean it.
But we can't take your money, right?
Yeah, plus I still owe you hundreds of thousands.
Really?
Yeah, Eddie was ripped off. Music festival went tits up.
Well, don't embarrass the poor boy.
I'm sorry, Eddie, but we want Mum to be financially stable, right?
Of course, yeah, keep it all.
500,000's enough for me.
Not if you want to buy a house.
Why, who said I wanted to do that?
Oh, you never know what's around the corner.
Well, Graham's house is perfectly lovely.
This time last year, you were happy as Larry with JMO. You hadn't had a stroke.
Oh, I can't believe you two.
What?
Here I am, I'm offering you a windfall and all you can do is come up with problems. Maeve, what do you think?
I think it's a stupendously generous offer.
See?
Mum, I know it's not in your nature, but you need to be sensible. You're at a certain stage in life.
She's calling me old, though.
You need to plan ahead, okay? You need to get some financial advice.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, you need to put yourself first. For once. You think that we should take the money?
It's none of my business.
$500,000 on the mortgage, that would feel so good.
Why do I feel like I'm getting trapped here?
Because that's what Mum does.
I don't get it.
Look, this money isn't a gift. It's a chain around my neck and yours.
She's just trying to be nice.
Mum doesn't do nice. She does control. Every move we make, she'll be there helping.
She does anyway.
Well, now she'll have ammo. I'll need to borrow the car, Nicole.
So?
If we tried to book a weekend away without her, she'd be offended.
She will not.
Oh, just forget about me. Forget about all the money that I gave you. It's just nothing. What?
How come I can see the good in your mum and you can't?
Because I know her better than you.
Okay, so she's a control freak, but look at you with your brother today.
Eddie?
You didn't even let him speak.
I did so.
As long as he agreed with you. But you were right about one thing. Your mum's getting older. She won't be around forever, and I think you kind of hurt her feelings.
See, this is what happens. I end up being the guilty one and having to say sorry. Not this time.
Oh, Esther, thanks for coming.
Mum has a big announcement. Another one.
Right, Eddie. I am not taking no for an answer this time.
I surrender.
I am waiving your debt no matter what. What'd you say?
I accept your generous offer. Well, thank you.
Yay. You thought it through on your own without your sister bullying you around.
It's about Kiwa, not me.
Kiwa's future is safe and sound, hey? My little trusted fairy in.
Your what?
And Belly. They're both getting trust funds with a big fat balance. Now, I sought financial advice, Nicole, so just say yes. It's safer this way. If Maeve runs off with a pretty young nurse...
Mum?
No, same goes for Esther. If she catches the eye of a hot young doctor, I wouldn't care less because my money is safe.
If I agree, will you stop talking about it?
Is that a yes?
And a thank you.
Wonderful. And I'll put a little bit on the mortgage as well. You can't stop me now.
Thank you again.
You are very welcome, darling.
That wasn't so hard, was it? You have no idea what has just been unleashed.
Service, quickly. We are celebrating here.
See? I'll be back in a sec.
Leanne, I don't know what to say.
Well, just choose the best schools for Kiwa. And the finest tutors in the country, field trips to Spain, let them have it all.
Yep, if I'm around to see it.
Oh, hey. No, we'll have none of that. This is our special family day.
Hi. Do you want an update?
Yes, please.
Mum is smiling.
It's great.
She's decided what to do with the money. Everyone's happy, so just try to let it go.
How can I? Your mum doesn't have all the money because Drew's tied it up.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah, it does.
Just come and talk to her. See for yourself.
I can't. Can you just go and be with your family, please?
Drew's still in trouble, huh?
Well, we'll be fine as soon as the divorce comes through.
Divorce is not funny, Harper. Boyd's on damage control as we speak.
Sorry?
His parents just split up. After all these years, the life they built together, the beautiful home, the safety and security of love, gone.
I'm sure they had their reasons.
You weren't joking, were you? No, Harper, you guys can't break up. Boyd and I, we talked about going out with you guys, dinner dates, holidays, your family coming over to our place, we go to yours, raising Billy and the twins together. So much chaos, but so much love.
He has gone too far this time.
Yes, he made a mistake, but he'll make it up to you.
I don't think he can.
Rejected my first offer, a four-way split. You and Eddie, Nicole and Maeve, Eric and Ginny and me.
You and Wang.
Your boyfriend.
Oh, of course.
So, what are you going to do with the rest of your money? All this free time? Something fun, I hope.
I won't let it change me. I'll continue with the fossil work, volunteering. Keeps me humble. Don't worry, Maeve. I haven't forgotten you.
I don't want any money.
No, but you'll be getting a bit, won't you? Via the mortgage. A substantial amount, actually.
Here we go.
You can afford to take me on holiday now.
Yes, cool.
Joining rooms, that'll be fun. Huh? Or maybe we could get Wilder into a new school.
There's no need for that.
Oh, well, he would look nice in a smart uniform and with a blazer. Probably need to get a haircut, of course. I bet you're dying to pick up the scissors and tidy up that mop. It's not like he needs long hair for cultural reasons. Ah, oh, yes, it's nothing like raising the bar for the family. I can see it all now. It's going to be my mission. Cheers.
Cheers.
Not getting a haircut.
Oh, Nana. Yeah,
well, Nana's not the boss of Wilder, is she?
Wait.
What? Shh, shh, shh. I'll call the police.
You're still inside.
Okay, let's go wait in the car, honey.
Babe. It's my brother.
Connor?
Can you hear me? Connor?
Great, he's on a bender in our house. That's awesome.
Connor,